join me. Good morning, beautiful people. Cory Julie here. Christmas Eve. Yes. All right, so. Oh, my goodness. I got a big shadow over there. I can see that. But otherwise, it's too dark in this room. So let's start off with our feet nice and white, guys, and let's shift side to side. Okay, that's funny. Look, it looks like I have a tail, and it's just swinging behind me. Side to side. Keep that chest lifted. Oh, yeah. So we're going to lift up that right leg on the next one. So lift and then place it back out nice and wide or just a short little step. Whatever feels best for your body on this beautiful Thursday morning. So a little bit of different Christmas music mixed in with some hot pop. Yes. Four more. Now, when you're warming up, guys, please make sure you're noticing how good your body feels. One more. And just go back to that side to side. Shift it to the right and to the left. Remember, I'll give you modifications. I'll give you progressions. You do you, I'll do me. And we'll get this workout in. Now let's go on the left leg. Lift and back out. Oh, yeah. Definitely not fast, but we will get that heart rate up and elevated. Nice. Good. You got about four more, and then we're going to take that left leg right into a reverse lunge, followed by the right leg. One more. Good. Reverse lunge and switch. Alternating reverse lunge. Now we're going to take the arm straight up to the sky. There we go. So from our side, guys, you're looking to go low. You're looking to kind of push that knee down towards the floor to open up your hip flexors and your quadriceps. Good. Ooh, mine are a little tight. Continue with the same legs. We're going to switch the arms to a nice, wide, open up, squeeze together, big hug. Good. Oh, yes. Good. One more time, back up to shoulders. So reach the arms to the sky. Pull down. Good. Increasing that breath, increasing that heart rate. 10 seconds, we'll do one more chest and back. Nice. Woo-hoo. Here we go, open. So right now, you should be able to reach a little bit lower. If you're tight, okay, your range of motion is going to be a lot shorter today. 10 seconds. Definitely don't grab your heaviest weight first unless you've been doing something prior just before this. Last one. Perfect. All right. Otherwise, grab a dumbbell, one dumbbell. So, the side that you have the dumbbell in, let's put it in your right side. Same leg is gonna stay anchored. Yes, it's gonna stay anchored, opposite leg. Reverse lunge, you're gonna hold, curl, shoulder press. You come up, lift the knee, bring the weight down, back into a jackknife to your flat tabletop, right into a dumbbell row, straight back up. Okay, so I gave the progression. One more time from the side. Reverse lunge, hold, hammer curl, shoulder press, lift the knee, bring it down, straight over, flat back, soft knee, raises down, dumbbell back row, straight back up. That's the progression. Obviously, you can come here, curl, shoulder shoulder press, bring it back down, come forward, hinge, never have to fully lift, be on one leg, and then dumbbell row without a knee lift. Guys, you're gonna do this nice and slow. You're doing it for 2 minutes. If you feel like 30 seconds into it, you feel warm and you wanna grab a heavier weight, grab a heavier weight. Here we go. Left leg, reverse lunge. Hold, hammer curl, shoulder press, come up, bring the weight down, drop the chest, lift the leg, push the chest to the floor, dumbbell row, knee lift, repeat, same side. I just added a knee lift through, that's extra. So it's just legs, core, shoulders, bicep, and back, right? Find your focus, find your breath. Excellent, good. From the side, reverse lunge, hold. And that reverse lunge, you're nice and low. Come up, release the weight, straight back. Dumbbell row. Take your gaze down to the floor. Reverse lunge, shoulders stacked over the hips. So a lot more standing core going on here. Flow through it. Just get a little bit heavier weight. Nice. You should be feeling the hamstring, butt, inner thighs, core, oblique, back, shoulder, bicep. Everything. It's such a great functional movement. Now, if you're looking at yourself in the mirror, pick a spot on the floor, find that spot, focus. Excellent. We'll do one more. So good. Take your time on them. Excellent, guys. When you finish that side, we're going right into the other side. Set it up. And remember, when the reverse lunge, keep your feet wider, especially if you don't feel you have good center balance today. The closer your feet are, the more you're going to be off balance. Keep that leg from going behind. It should be off to the side. Here we go. 3, 2, reverse lunge, hammer curl, shoulder press, option of long arm. It's up to you. Lunge over. Good. Back to a knee lift. I like it, Sandy. Reverse lunge. Shoulder press. So just that arm to the ceiling as you come back out of that lunge. It's a lot of extra core. A lot of extra strength going on. I love it. Modify. Set the knee down. Come back. Bring it here. What you want to avoid is just giving up, right? We can do this. We can try. Excellent. Beautiful, guys. 1 minute down, 1 minute to go. Got a little windy in here. Squeeze that butt in the reverse lunge. Flat back before you row. Find that center to where your shoulders and your hips are square to the floor. Reverse lunge. Press it. Remember, every day is a challenge just to try something new. See if you could get a little more technique, a little bit bigger range of motion than yesterday. Excellent, guys. Coming into your last couple. Standing leg is soft. That knee is slightly bent. One of my favorite songs. Finish it out, and that will be your last one. Excellent, guys. Okay, so we're going to go to a crunch. So I want you to grab a little bit lighter set of weights. I have some threes, some twos, and then a little bit heavier. So I'm gonna go a little bit heavier to start with, but you'll probably see me switching out during. So once you come up into the crunch, your thumbs are to the ceiling, you're here, you open up, you squeeze that together, you lower down at the same time you reverse crunch. Okay, on the reverse crunch, touch the tailbone, down slow, slow, slow. What you do with the weights here is up to you, okay? So you can leave the weights, support your neck, come up, and then grab the weights and give me this T. Yes or yes? If you do need to support your neck, then definitely grab the weights once you're at the top. You wanna add a little bonus, leave the weights longer, tuck down, inhale, exhale, come up, thumbs to ceiling, open to a T, come back to center, lower back down. Yes or yes? Hey guys, so we're gonna do these slow. Again, 2 minutes, not about speed, it is about opening, push your chest. When you come up in this V-sit, if you wanna progress, you can lift the knees. If that's too much to where you're rounding your back, do not do that. Keep your feet, legs slightly bent, and come up higher versus clear back here. It's up to you. All right, 3, 2, let's get it. Come on, my little elves. Open, tuck the tailbone, down slow. Now, if you wanna set the weights on the floor, do it. You find where you're working to your strength, getting them stronger, working towards those weaknesses. Beautiful. Nice, Michelle. Hi, Jane. Yes. All in. Nice, nice. So guys, I will give you a little tip. Push your chest out as you come up, okay? So I want a flat back. Beautiful, Sandy. Nicely in. Oh, yeah. Now, if you fatigue through your arms, then I want you to keep the weights out of it and just do your arms, but continue through that crunch, okay? So that's what we're kind of focused on here is the crunch, and then the arms come second. How about if you fatigue, you do one weight, one crunch, and then no weight, and the crunch. Many ways we could keep moving. 1 minute down, 1 minute to go. So you're hitting shoulder. 4. A little bit of that posterior deltoid. Come on now, don't you stop on me. Guys, I got my big screen. I can see you now. That little one, I could not see anybody. Doesn't matter how close or how far. Coming in to the last 30 seconds. We're gonna come up. We're gonna do more legs. We're gonna do chest. So in and out and by, coming your way with a little bit of a chest scoop. Woo! We could get 2 more good ones in. Slow. Beautiful. Woo! I love seeing you guys do it with your legs up. This will be your last one. And excellent. Hi, up to Daisy. You need water, guys, get it? Otherwise, going right into a side lunge. Now, you have 2 dumbbells. You're gonna scoop. So let me remind you, when you scoop, fingers, palm, thumb, everything is facing the ceiling, okay? Never down. Thumbs, everything is facing the ceiling. You're gonna come across your body and up. So the pinky, the whole palm goes to the ceiling just like you're a server back in the day. I know some of you guys waitress like I did. So it's gonna be opposite side. We're gonna step to the right, okay? Side step, you come up, you scoop across. And that's all we're doing on this side. So this is the modified scoop across. This is the progression. Here, hold the knee, ho, 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 hold the knee, scoop across, and then step out. so that knee lift is extra bonus. Yes, yes? Here we go. 3, 2, side step, dive on, hold. Hold it up there, especially if your weight's lighter. Try to resist letting that dumbbell pull you back down to the floor. A little more oblique. Abductor, adductor, gorgeous. Pinky, thumb, palm to the ceiling. Scoop that ice cream. Excellent, yes. How high can we lift that knee to the chest? Can we get it higher? Yes, I'll give you a side. Merry Christmas. Woo! On that side lunge, your chest leans forward a little bit. Your hip goes way behind you. Coming up on 1 minute. Now, if it was just for the chest and you're fatiguing, you have a heavy weight, leave out the chest, continue with the legs. The legs, I definitely like to do at least 2 minutes of repetition. Modification, just that side lunge. Short, third step. Got less than 30 seconds. Good, Michelle. Now I can see you instead of just your garage door. So try not to drop your chest too much. So you're not trying to go to the floor like this, guys. Make sure you keep that chest lifted. There you go. Show me your name tag. One more. And we're reversing it right into the other side. Feet together. Step to your left. Toe tap. Come across. Next one's possession, knee lift. Come across, down slow. Quick, hold slow, come across. This side is not letting me work today. I think it's the light, so bright. Excellent. So find that breath. You want to inhale. You want to exhale as you scoop that weight towards the ceiling. Good. Try to hold that leg a little longer. Beautiful. Thumb, palm to the ceiling. Show me that platter. Chest stays lifted. Excellent. 1 minute. Oh, yes, you can. Remember, chest, you worked it yesterday. It's okay. Just go right here. Go right into just a side step to the knee lift. Going into the last 30 seconds, team. Looking so good. Where's your hot, Naj? Is it getting too hot? Definitely hold the heat in. One more. Woo! Excellent, guys. All right, coming down to the floor. Back to core. Choices, knees down. Or elbows down. You're gonna do a dumbbell pull through, okay? So what I want you to do is get one dumbbell, heavy. You're on the outside of it. The dumbbell is slightly behind your wrist, okay? So show it from the side. Slightly behind my wrist. I'm out in front of it. I'll do knees down first. What I'm gonna do is reach through with the opposite hand, pull it through, set it down. Opposite hand, pull through. Set it down. One more time with the regression. and the elbows spiral towards each other. Pull through. Hold. Pull through. Okay, how do I do it? Progression, you guys know. But I'm gonna cue you. If your feet are close together, you're gonna get a lot of junk in the trunk. I want you to not move your hips at all. In fact, if I take a 2-pound dumbbell, place it on my back, okay, right on my lower back. If I come up and just roll down my butt, remember to tighten your butt. I want that dumbbell to stay there and not move. So I reach through. So my pelvis is not rocking at all. Anything, put something light. Don't let it come off, okay? When you need to, stop pulling through. You're gonna do this for 1 minute, okay? Hold the plank. You can do shoulder taps. Opposite hand, hold that through, yes or yes? Going in 3, 2, feet a little bit wider, let's go. Keep both hips facing the floor. Now, this is a breeze for you. I want you to bring your feet closer together and then see if it's still a breeze for you. Are the hips all of a sudden rocking? You got it, you got it. Aaron, your hips are rocking just a little. Drop the pelvis just a little, yes! Nice, Andy. Come on, Marissa. What? Lydia, come on, girl. Nice, Leanne. Is John in there? Hello! Yes, you got it. You got 15 seconds, guys. You're doing this for 1 minute. 5, 4, 3, 2. Woo-hoo! Come on up, kids. Nice work. All right, so you're going to give me a bicep curl. Regular bicep curl, palms are facing up. Yes or yes? So you did hammer curl here. And when you do a regular bicep curl, I want you to watch your elbow. See where my elbow is still to the floor? If I bring it up closer to my shoulder, my elbow moves. See that? Do not allow that, okay? I don't care if your elbow's here, but don't avoid your elbow continuing to travel forward. You're just using the shoulders when you do that. So when you curl, you want to stop. Everybody's a little different range. Right there's my range. If I bring it any further, the elbow moves. Now, I have 2 different weights. You have the same weight. I'm only doing a little bit heavier in my left because it's a little weaker, and I want to get a little extra. So guys, you're going to alternate reverse curtsy. So you're here, curl, come up with a knee lift, opposite side, curl, come up with a knee lift. That's the progression. The regression is what? Let me put my earpiece back in. Santa's hat, pulled it back out. My ear's sweaty. Okay. So the regression is your knee stays down and you curl here and then you just come back up. If that's too much, you still go into a reverse curtsy, come up, and then you curl right here. You're gonna still do these guys for 2 minutes. So if your arms give out, continue to do the legs. One other cue, when you give me a reverse curtsy, look at your knee, it's in line with your ankle. Not here, not here, here, here. So everybody's reverse curtsy is a little bit different. If you wanna work more butt, you hinge forward and then do the biceps at the top. Yes or yes? We're gonna alternate, we're going in 10 seconds. I'm gonna go to the right side, okay? 3, 2, let's go. Reverse curtsy, bicep curl, knee lift. Feet wide, reverse curtsy, curl, knee lift. Feet hip width apart. Beautiful. Front foot has all the weight on it. Excellent. Take your time with these. You can also come up and curl just like I did there. I need 2 more video models. One that shows modified, and I'll show the easiest and then the other person could do the hardest. Reverse. Curl. Excellent. So, this is the other head of the bicep. Excellent. How are you holding the dumbbells? If you're feeling it in your forearm, take the thumb around the same direction so everything's going towards the ceiling. It'll lighten your grip. It'll help you not use the brachioradialis for the forearm. Love it. Excellent. Good, Aaron. That's it. You got it, John. Ooh-hoo. Keep going. He's making our list. Excellent. Keeping your abs tight. Now guys, you're strong. I want to see that back knee going low. A lot of inner thigh. Love my reverse curtsies. Less than 30. Going back down to the floor for some triceps. Skull crushers, tricep extensions, whatever you want to call them. One more each side. Excellent. Nice work. All right. So every other one, if you notice, I bring your heart rate down and we've worked a core. So we're still going to work a core unless your option is to leave the feet on the floor. And you can bridge and work more butt and hamstring. So you could take your feet close to your butt and give me a bridge, keeping the knees apart, knees together, up to you. Or you could tabletop the legs, and as you drop the weight, you extend the legs behind you, and then you extend and bring them back up. Yes or yes? So triceps with core, triceps with glute or hamstring, your choice, or just triceps. Now, I do want two weights to stay apart until you fatigue and your form changes, then push them together. Yes or yes? That way that right arm or that non-dominant arm has to work just as hard to join the party. All right, guys, here we go. 3, 2, 2 minutes. Let's go. Be conscious. What you're feeling in your lower back. Remember to squeeze your Kegels, breathe, and avoid the wrist flicking in any direction. Hold a neutral position, look at your wrist, that block at the top. There's my reindeer. Rudolph, where have you been? Don't stand on me, you big dork. Find that breath. At any point you feel the back and you're doing your legs, take them more diagonal to the ceiling. If you feel your hip flexors, let your knees pull out to the side. I had reindeer antlers on him, but it won't work. I don't know any dog that likes those reindeer antlers. Got less than 1 minute, guys. Notice what your triceps are doing. They should be burning right now. If they're not, drop it down a little slower. If your weight is not as heavy as you'd like it to be or as strong as you would like it to be, drop them down slow. Resist that gravity. Make sure you're locking at the very top. Just like with the biceps, notice your elbows. They stay pointed to the ceiling and they're not moving forward or back. through the motion. Woohoo! I love it! Less than 15 seconds. Excellent, Sandy. I see some of you guys got your weights pressed together. You're still going. You're crushing it. Give me 5, 4, 3, 2. Yeah, Michelle. Excellent. All right, guys. So one time through, you did most of it for 2 minutes. Guess what? We're going through it now, and we're doing everything again for 1 minute. Get up. Let's go. Get it. We got 15 minutes to crush it. Right, Bubba? Look at Bossy go. All right, so whatever leg you want to start with, guys. I'll start with my left, which I'll be cueing your right. Remember, reverse lunge for 1 minute. 3, 2, reverse lunge. Hold, hammer curl, shoulder press. Lift the knee, bring the weight down. Jackknife, tabletop, whatever you want to call it, single leg deadlift, and here we go. Dumbbell row, release, high knee lift. Repeat. Quick is not the key. Sometimes that'll elevate your heart rate. But how could I elevate my heart rate? I could either give a bigger range of motion, a heavier weight, right? Think about what your goal is. You don't have to elevate that heart rate when you're lifting weights. Reverse lunge. Knee can be down. Shoulder press. Good. Give me one more. See how fast that 1 minute started. Woohoo! A little windy in here. Excellent. Let's go right to the other side. Are we ready? 3, 2, reverse lunge. Hold. Hammer curl. Shoulder press. Knee lift. Release the arm. Back leg nice and long. Bird dog. Row. Knee lift. Reverse lunge. Hammer curl. Shoulder press. Knee lift. Bring the weight down. Square the shoulders, square the hips to the floor. Spread the toes. Knee lift. Excellent. Repeat. Gorgeous. So good. Telling yourself, I'm so glad I get to work out today. I'm so glad I'm feeling strong. Excellent. Guys, we're gonna crush one more. One more, the best. Lift the knee, reverse lunge, shoulder press. Excellent. All right, go on, dumbbell. Please. A wonderful Christmas time. He wants to go outside and play. I was hoping there'd be snow. I'm gonna hook you up. Alrighty, are we ready? So, you got the crunch. You come up, thumbs to the ceiling, thumbs to a T, back down, and release. I want you to go down slow, team. Here we go. 3, 2, down slow. Inhale, exhale, coming up. Thumb, open, back together, release down. Where you lift the weights when you start to come up is all choice. You wanna wait till you come up and then lift them? Excellent. But notice if you're rounding, if you are, sit up taller, okay? Extend those arms, beautiful. That's it, Michelle. If you have heavier weights, you can just go wide and then send them down there. Up to you. So I can leave them in that T position and then lift up. You still have that external rotation protecting the shoulder. You're hitting a little bit of the back of the shoulder and the medial deltoid. And yes, of course, the front of the shoulder, the anterior. Less than 15 seconds. Beautiful. One more. Tuck. Breathe out. Open. Together. And lower down. Nice work, guys. All right, we're going into the scoop. We're going to step to your right. You're going to lift. Stay to one side for 1 minute. Going in 5, 4, 3, 2. Here we go. Side step. Hold the knees. Cross. Palm, thumb, pinky to the ceiling. Now remember, your knee is not down here. It's nice and high. And then you cross over your midline. Go in the direction in the muscle of the muscle fibers of the chest. We hit everything today. Butt, hamstring, inner and outer thigh, shoulders, back, chest, biceps and triceps. So if you're feeling this in your biceps, notice if you're curling or are you pushing it out away from your body. I want you to push it out. You'll use a little bit, but I want a lot more chest. I want you feeling that right around that armpit all the way over to the center. Good. Come across. Last one. Excellent. Going right into the other side. Woo! How we doing? Thumbs up. You guys are crushing it. Let's go. Left side. Hold. Lift the knee. Left side is lunge. Lift the knee. Beautiful. Get that pinky to the ceiling. If it limits how far you can go across your body, it's okay. I just want everything in that palm facing the ceiling. Gorgeous. Nice. Modified is no knee lift. Excellent, Don. 15 seconds. So remember, team, sometimes reps are really good. Endurance. Sometimes if you have a heavier weight, 8 to 10 reps is great as well. If you do both, you're going to be in awesome shape. Last one. Good. Dumbbell pull through. If you are like most bodybuilders, they don't do any cardio. You want to do a little bit. You could always increase your range of motion, increase that heart rate if you don't like that cardio. It'll elevate your heart rate. Or do functional movements as we're doing now. So high plank or knees down or elbows down. Let's go. Feet apart. Pull through. Opposite arm. Notice the hips are not moving. Notice, when you pull and reach through, are you lifting your stomach or your butt towards the ceiling? So notice, no movement, Naj, no movement, Sandy. Excellent. Good, good, good. Oh, that is perfect. So those of you who have nailed it, keep going. Just move your feet a little closer together. Gorgeous. That's it, John. Nicely, Ann. Got less than 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and woohoo! Nice work. All right, we got two more things, guys. You got the reverse curtsy with a regular bicep curl. You're gonna alternate side to side, and then you have your triceps. Cool down, stretch, and you're completely done. You're ready to finish what you have left for Christmas. All right, shoulders stacked. Here we go, reverse curtsy. Right leg behind, hold, curl, knee lift, opposite side. Oh, downward dog. somebody's a camera. Not camera shy. You're alternating. Your palms are going to the ceiling. You're adding that extra knee lift. Thank you. If your dog is getting in the way, change it up. So it's funny, did I tell you guys the turkey here, the wild turkey that goes through our yard every day, as well as the deer? They're as tall as he is, their legs, just their legs. I've never seen such tall turkey. Have you, Bubba? Have you seen tall turkey? Coming in the last set, guys, less than 15 seconds. Who do you see? Who do you see, Bubba? Who do you see? Last one! Thank you, buddy. I know. All right, guys, we're finishing up with triceps. Grab your weight. Would you move? I can't get my weight. Would you grab my hat? All right, it's playtime. What? Are you gonna grab that weight? Pick it up. All right, starting the triceps in 5. Wow, that's pretty strong. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. Last thing, triceps, 1 minute. Feet on the floor, working, or up in the air, tabletop, working your core. Keep those weights apart. Push the elbows back down behind you. If you have light weight, reach back farther. You can go ahead. You're just happy, guys. You're just happy. Somebody's a happy boy. Did we just switch out of my Christmas stuff? What? We did. Wow. 41 minutes, not 45. Merry, merry, merry Christmas. You guys got less than 30 seconds. I love it. Kool-Aid man, you ready for Christmas? Oh, yeah. Ready for Christmas, Bobo? All I really want for Christmas. Last one? Excellent, guys. All right. So, come on down. We're going to do a stretch. So, I want a runner's lunge. I want one leg in front. The opposite knee is on the floor. And then just kind of open the chest. And when you're ready, go ahead and lift the leg behind you. Lift that leg, whichever hand feels better to lift that leg. Oh, yeah. They're looking at you. You knock me over every time. Yeah. What? Does anybody want to borrow a Great Dane for a bit? Somebody that's feisty. Keep holding that stretch. Nice job you today, guys. Happy holidays. Hope you have a great Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. Good. Release the foot. I want you to take that same arm and reach it down the center of your back, stretching your triceps, and at the same time, you're still stretching that quadricep. Squeeze that butt cheek. Probably shouldn't have started that. Now he's going to chew him. Look, you already put a hole in it, knucklehead. No. Sit. Bo. Not on me. Sit. No. And then we're going to go right into a hamstring stretch, guys. So come down on the floor, sit, take the sole of the foot into the inner thigh. And then take the arms forward, cross over the knee, and just hinge a little bit. If you want to feel the stretch in your lower back, Then round over. Down. Good boy. Good boy. No, don't chew on my hat. I know. And this is a round for the lower back. Otherwise, arms up and then cross. Keeping that pelvis and the anterior tilt to help that hamstring stretch. No. I just wanted to see if you could pick up a 7, and you did. So I could tell you have a strong mouth. Good. And then come up, and we're going into opposite side, runner's lunge. Coming forward. Squeezing that butt cheek. And when you're ready, grab that leg behind. If it feels tight, release a little bit. But the closer you bring, with your hips still faced in the same direction, you're anchored into that front heel, your chest is lifted, your abs are in tight. Ooh, this is the side that's a little tight on me. So guys, Pilates Fusion on Saturday at 10:30. I am also doing Cycle at 9 a.m. via Zoom. So if you guys have a bike and you wanna join me, feel free. Oh, release that leg. Take that opposite arm for the tricep stretch. Squeeze the butt. Good. Release it down. Take the sole of the foot to the inner thigh. Arms reach towards your toes and then cross over and then hinge a little bit. As soon as you start to round the back, you've just lost the stretch in the hamstring. So just hold, breathe through it. And remember, if you have an opportunity, you have a foam roller, you have a SOAS tool back here on my fireplace, those are great. If you want to know about the SOAS with the hip flexors, just message me. That is something I do every day, and I have really had no issues with my hip flexors since I've been doing that. You can get them on Amazon. It's just PSOAS muscle tool. And release. Good. Bring the feet back together. Come all the way up, guys. We're going to stand with your feet hip width apart. I want you to bend your knees, shift your hips back. So right there is a hamstring stretch. Interlock the fingertips behind your back. Push the chest out and lift the arms away from your body. Feel the stretch through your shoulders, through your chest. If you want to push back a little bit farther, then you'll feel a little more hamstring. Good. Release the arms. Coming all the way back up. Thank you so much, guys. Big inhale. Bring the hands together. Down to heart center. You were awesome today. Thank you.
Thank you, Mary.